talking to you. Catch up. The last time we talked about the shorter earrings that I make, as well as Artil's grandfather that went missing. And I am here to report that I've done some further research and went back over some of my documents that I did have. And remember I told you that the grandmother, our grandmother, my sweetheart's grandmother, was actually shot by a gun that was being cleaned by her dad. And that was around 1913. Well, there just so happens that there were two major explosions in New Mexico in the Dawson, New Mexico mine. Over 260 men were lost in that mine accident. And then later on, I believe 1921, there was another accident that took about 130 people's lives in the same area in New Mexico. Now, I believe that there's somewhere in there between 1913 and 1920, we lose Grandpa, the great-grandpa. His name was Jose Zavala Perez, and I believe that because he's here in New Mexico in 1910, living in a home with his wife, Maria. She and his brother, Griego Zavala, and a boarder that they had, along with a couple of children, are in that home. But after 1920, in the 1920 census, we lose him completely. I don't find him. I do find that Maria goes on and is remarried, and they have a half-brother who is a Huerta on the last name. So things have changed. Still just trying to find that mystery and where it all goes. But what we do know for sure is Josefa, the little girl that was shot, grew up. She married her husband, and he was, his name was Para. And they lived in 1930 in the census for Mexico. I find them living in Santa Ana, Ascension, Chihuahua, Mexico. She has Victor, who's the tío that I was talking to, who's in his 90s. And she has Refugio, or we called her Tia Cuca. She's since passed away here not too terribly many years ago. Anyways, just very interesting, but that's in 1930, she's there. So I still have a lot of homework to do on that. And it's always just so intriguing and exciting. You can find mine accidents just by Googling. You can ask, and there are mine companies that keep record of that. Again, I really feel like that's a really great possibility, but I can't quite find his name where I need it yet. So I don't want to say that's exactly what happened, because there are so many things that are possible that could have happened during that time. Today, I just wanted to also do a couple of shout-outs. Tomorrow is the 18th of October, and the Choctaw Nation celebrates wanting to wear purple in celebration of ending domestic violence. So if you feel like joining in, just a little bit something about the culture there. Wear some purple tomorrow. Let's stop some domestic violence anywhere, not just on the nation, but anywhere. And I want to do a special shout out to my sweetheart's daughter, Monica. It's her birthday today. Happy birthday, honey. She's very young still. She's got 9 children, and she's just a really great mom. So wishing her a happy birthday today. Wanted to show you these earrings. These are just some more of what I'm doing, you know, me and my art stuff. So they kind of have the same patterns, but I try to change them up with colors and looks, and I change the patterns on them as well as I can. And they just come across really pretty, though, and they're shiny and remind me of little lights when they twinkle. I think for today, that's where I'm going to leave you. Please watch your families. Take care of them. Remember, it just takes a second for somebody to change your life forever. And watch your children, especially close.